Hello, this is Mr. Stansberry. I'm going to take you through the 14J notes on probabilities from Venn diagrams. At the end of this, you should be able to say, I can use Venn diagrams to solve and represent various compound events. All right, so let's get right into it. First thing is example 19 from page 42. The Venn diagram illustrates the number of people in a sporting club who play unicycle polo, represented by UP, and toe wrestling. TW. Determine the number of people in the club who toe wrestle, play both sports, play neither sport, play at least one sport. Okay, so we're going to use this Venn diagram here to answer all these questions. Okay, so, the total number of people in the club will be all of these four groups of people. So these 15 people just play unicycle polo. These 27 people do unicycle polo and toe wrestling. These 26 do just toe wrestling, and then these 7 don't do either. Okay, so the total number of people in the club is just simply going to be 15 plus 27 plus 26 plus 7, which if you add those all up, you get 75 people. All right, next, who toe wrestle? Now, these 26 people toe wrestle, but these 27 people toe wrestle and play unicycle polo, so we have to add those two together. So it's 27 and 26. It's everybody inside this circle. All right, add those together, and we get 53. All right, who play both sports? That's just this middle group here, because that's the overlap on this, so... that's just going to be 27 people altogether. Okay. People who play neither sport are the people that are outside both of those circles, so that would be 7 people. All right. And then play at least one sport. So that would be, these people play just unicycle polo, these people play just toe wrestling, and these people do both. So it says, it doesn't say exactly one sport, but at least one sport. So we're going to add all three of those together. Okay, so that's going to be, There we go. So we're going to add 15 and 27 and 26, which gives us 68 people. Okay. Another way that you could have done this is you could have taken the 75 total people and subtracted 7, and that would also give you 68, either way. All right. Okay, let's do a little video break here, and this is more game show answers. These just kill me for some reason.
All over the world, something Russia's famous for, Bob.
Russians.
Name an animal with three letters in its name. You said frog. Our survey said zero. Two people would have to say that. Something that comes with a summer storm. You gave me the answer. Snow. Our survey said... Remind everyone to Bob's shame. The answers he gave us...
That's the same guy as before.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Name an animal with three letters in its name.
Alligator.
Yeah, that was all the same family there. Go figure. Okay. Anyway, let's see. Let's take a look at the second and last example here. And that is, in a class of 30 students, 19 study Elvish, the language of Lord of the Rings, and then 17 study philosophy and Star Trek. And by the way, these are both actual classes offered at college universities. I think one of them's University of Wisconsin, and I can't remember the other one. Anyway, I just thought that was interesting. So, and then 15 people study both subjects. Display this information on a Venn diagram and hence determine the probability that a randomly selected class member studies both subjects at least one, Elvish but not philosophy, exactly one, neither subject, philosophy, known that the student studies Elvish. So, first thing we want to do is we want to represent this in a Venn diagram. Excuse me. So, we have to figure out what goes in each one of these four regions, right? Just Elvish, just Philosophy of Star Trek and Star Trek, who do both, and then who do neither would be out here. Okay, so usually the best idea on this here is to try to find this middle piece here. Okay, so 19 study Elvish, 17 study philosophy, 15 study both subjects. So that's our key here, is that 15 people study both. Okay, now we can go back and say we know that there's 17 that study philosophy and Star Trek, so there's got to be 17 people inside this circle. There's already 15 in here, so we just have two more that study just the philosophy, not Z more, but two more. There we go. That study just the philosophy and Star Trek. And then if you go back, there's 19 that study Elvish. Again, there's 15 that are already here, so we have four more to make 19. Okay, so we know that there's 30 total students, so let's see. Let's figure out what this number that comes out here. So we'll do 30 minus 4 plus 15 plus 2. So that's going to be 30 minus 15, 19, 21. Gives us 9. So that 9 is going to go out here. Okay, now that we have this, hopefully these questions should be pretty easy. Okay, so the number of people that study both subjects, it even tells us right here, 15. Okay. But it's actually asking us to determine the probability, so that is not our answer. It's 15 out of the total people, which is 30 total people, which gives us 50% probability. And again, probability you can leave as a percent or a decimal, doesn't matter. Okay. How many people study at least one subject? So that is going to be the 4, the 15, and the 2. So 4 plus 15 plus 2 all over 30. Which is going to be 21 out of 30. And let's see, let's use our calculator for that. 21 divided by 30 we can do as 70%. All right. Elvish but not philosophy. So the number of people that do Elvish but not philosophy is those 4 out of 30. All right, so we calculate that. 4 divided by 30 gives us 13.3%. Unless they state otherwise, it's usually best to go out to like the nearest tenth on percents when you're finding probabilities. Okay, exactly one subject is going to be these four people who study just Elvish, and then these two people who study just philosophy and Star Trek. So that's going to be 6 out of 30. And let's see, 6 divided by 30 gives us 20%. Number of people that study neither subject would be these 9, so that's 9 out of 30. 9 divided by 30. Don't mind my voice cracking. That's all right, so that's 30%. And then last one, this one, these get a little tricky, so you have to understand what they're asking here. So what's the probability that a class member studies philosophy if it's already known that the student studies Elvish? So we know that it's given that it's only these people here that we're choosing from, okay? So it's given that the person studies Elvish. So the important part here is the bottom is going to be the 4 plus 15, so let's just do this, 4 plus 15, so that's 19, okay? And then of these 19 people, how many people study philosophy? There's the 15, so we end up with 15 out of 19, so we use our handy-dandy calculator for that, and we do 15 divided by 19, and we get 78.9%. All right. Okay, so that's it for this one. If you should be able to say now that I can use Venn diagrams to solve and represent various compound events. If you have questions, please ask. Thanks.